So this is problem number 4, was asked in November 2016 for 17 marks. Okay, so first I will read this problem and then I will solve. Okay, so design a rectangular beam section 250 mm wide and 500 mm overall depth. Okay, subjected to ultimate values, all values are ultimate. Bending moment 80 km/m, shear force 80 km, torsional moment 60 km/m, and take effective cover 50 mm on top and bottom. Use M20 and Fe415. This is the problem. Okay, all values are in ultimate condition. Okay, so there is no need to convert these values into ultimate load condition by multiplying 1.5. Okay, and you have to solve this problem with Lemmstedt method. Okay, so first I will write down all these given values at the top of the board. Width of beam is 250 mm. Okay, overall depth is 500 mm. Okay, so ultimate bending moment mu is, ultimate bending moment is 80 km/m. Okay, 80 kN/m. Ultimate shear force Vu. Ultimate shear force Vu is again 80 kN. Okay, ultimate torsional moment Tu is 60 kN. Is 60 km/m, and you have to use the M20 and Fe415. Effective cover for both sides is 50 mm. Okay, so now I want to solve this problem. Okay, so what is the first step? Okay, so step number 1 is equivalent shear force VE. Okay, so how it is calculated? VU plus 1.6 TU upon B. Okay, so this is equivalent shear force. What is the VU? VU is 80, 1.6 TU is 60, and width of section is 250. That means you have to put this value in meter. Now I will calculate. It is 60 divided by 0.250 into 1.6 is 384. So 80 plus 384 plus 80, it is 464 kN. Look the amount. In general condition, the shear force is 80. If you consider the effect of a torsional moment, the change in value is 80 to 464 kN. There is a vast difference between in these values. Okay. Step 2, calculate equivalent shear stress. Calculate equivalent shear stress. That is, tau VE is equal to VE divided by V into D. So what is the VE? 464 into 10 raised to 3. Width of the section is 250. And depth is 500. 500 is the overall depth. You have to deduct the 50 mm effective cover from that value. So 464 into 10 raised to 3 divided by 250 into 450. Okay. The value is 4.12 MPa. So this value is comparatively very high. Okay. Now, Now you have to find out the two more shear stresses. One is tau c, another is tau c max. Okay. So permissible shear stress in concrete. Permissible shear stress in concrete. It is tau c, but for that you have to assume PT. Assume PT 0.5%. Assume PT 0.5%. For 0.5% PT, so tau c is 0.48 megapascal. 0.48 megapascal for M20 grade concrete. For M20 grade concrete with the reference of Table 19, the reference of table 19. Okay, I will show that table. Okay. On page number 73, that table is available. Okay. And from that, the value is 0.5%. The value is for M20 grade concrete is 0.48. Okay. Now what about tau c max? So tau c max is 2.8 megapascal for M20 grade concrete. That table is table 20 from IS-456. From IS-456. Okay. Now you have to compare all these values. Now you have to compare all these values. So what is comparison? Look the value of tau c max. Tau c max is 2.8. And look the value of tau ve, it is 4.12. Tau ve is more than tau c max. So what is the condition here? So tau ve is more than tau c max is more than tau c. It is 4.12 is more than 2.8 is more than 0.48. That is, it is very dangerous case. That means the shear force is very high and the provided dimensions are very less. So in such condition, in this condition, what you have to do, you have to think about three approaches. One is increase the dimensions, that means you have to increase the width and depth, or you have to change only width. And last one is a very shortcut, that means you have to change the grade of concrete without doing so much revisions. There is one shortcut, is you have to change the grade of concrete. So now I am going to adopt change the grade of concrete. Now change grade of concrete. Now which concrete you have to adopt? For tau c max, from table 20, the tau c max is, tau c max is for M40 grade concrete and above, it is 4. That means you have to adopt the maximum grade of concrete to take this type of equivalent shear stress. That means take M40 grade concrete. Take M40 grade concrete. So for M40 grade concrete and above, so for M40 grade concrete and above, M40 grade and concrete above, for M40 grade concrete and above of that, and above, the value of tau c max is 4 megapascal. The value of tau c max is 4 megapascal. Now you have to solve this problem by considering that this value is nearly equal to 4 megapascal. That means Now here, tau c max really equal to tau ve is more than tau c. More than tau c. That means tau c max is 4, and you have to say that it is nearly equal to this and this point. Now tau c value for M40 grade is, for 0.5% M40 grade is, I'm going to check it, 0.51. It is 0.51 megapascal for M40 grade particle. So 0.51 megapascal. Considering these values, now you have to solve the problem. So here shear and longitudinal reinforcement required. Shear and longitudinal reinforcement required. Okay, is it clear? We have changed the grade of concrete because the tau ve overtakes the value of tau c max. Okay, so what is the value of tau ve? Tau ve is 4.12 megapascal. Okay, what is the value of tau c? It is 0.51 megapascal. Okay, so these values are we have to use in further steps. Okay, so now what about the longitudinal reinforcement? Step number 3. Okay, what about the longitudinal steel? So longitudinal steel is designed for the bending moment M1. So you first have to find out the equivalent bending moment. It is M1. So M1 is equal to mu plus mt. So mu, we have the formula mt tu into 1 plus capital D by V divided by 1.7. okay, so mu is 80, tu is 61, capital D 500, 250 and 1.7. so this is the mu1. So 80 plus, now I have to calculate these values. Okay, so 1 plus 2, okay, 500 divided by 250 makes it is 2, 3 divided by 1.7 into 60, this value is 105.88. okay, so plus 80, so this is 185, okay, correct, 185.88 kilonewton meter. So this is value of equivalent bending moment ME1, and for this value you have to design the longitudinal tension reinforcement. Now to check that whether this beam is under reinforcement or not, for that you need to find out MUR balance. MUR balance is RU balance BD square. For Fe415, the RU balance is 0.138 FCK. Okay, so MUR balance is 185. You have to find out the MUR balance. Okay, 0.138. Now FCK is 40 because we have changed the grade of concrete. Width is 250, have to find out the depth. Depth is 450 square. By deducting the effective cover 50, so you get the value 450. So 0.138, 40 into 250 into 450 into 450. Okay, the value is 279.45 kilonewton meter. By comparing these two values, so ME1 is less than mu r balance. So the section is acting as under reinforced section. Section is acting as under reinforced section. Okay, isn't it? So now you have to use this value to find out the steam. So directly go on finding the steel. So there is the 185.88. So this is the value of mu. Okay, this is the value of mu. We need the value ME1. ME1 is 185.88, and what is the MT? MT is, I think, is 105.88. 105.88. So this is the MT. Okay. So steel calculation. Steel calculation is AC is equal to 0.5 FCK divided by FY into bracket 1 minus under root of magnitude of this. Okay, so 1 minus 4.6 ME1. Okay, FCK BD square into BD. So 0.5 FCK is 40. FY is 415, 1 minus under root of 1 minus 4.6 ME1. ME1 is 185.88 into 10 raised to 6 divided by FCK is 40, width is 250, okay, depth is 450 square, 250 into 450. Okay, so now you have to find out the value. So I will calculate this 4.6 185.88 into 10 raised to 6 divided by 40 into 250 into 450 into 450, 0.4222. So 1 minus 0.4222 under root of answer 0.760, 1 minus 0.760 into 0.5 into 40 divided by 415 into 250 into 450. The value is 1301.20 mm square. So let us assume 20 mm diameter bar. Number of bar is 1301.20 divided by pi by 420 square. Okay, divided by pi by 4, 20 into 20, 20 into 20, okay, this is 4.14, so instead of that, I am going to change the diameter of bar 25 mm, okay, so 1301.20 divided by pi by 4 into 25 into 25, now it is okay, it is 2.65, it is 2.65 means 3. Okay, now you have to provide the 25 mm 3 bars as a tension strip. Okay, is it clear? Now what about the compression steel? So numerical value of MT exceeds the numerical value of MU. The MT is 105.88 and MU is 80. So obviously the numerical value of MT is more than numerical value of MU. Compression steel is required. Compression steel required. So now you have to design the compression steel for bending moment ME2. Now compression steel is, now compression steel is, okay, compression steel is, for that we have to find out the ME2. ME2 is simple difference of ME and MU. ME2 is nothing but a simple difference of these two bending moment. It is 105.88 minus 80, Okay, 105.8 minus 80. So this value is only 25.88 kilonewton meter. Okay, 25.88 kilonewton meter. So how to find out the compression steel? You know that Me2 divided by FAC into D minus DC. Me2 is the bending moment, FAC is the stress in compression steel, D minus DC is the approximate labor arm. Okay, so Me2 is 25.88 into 10 raised to 6 divided by, now what is the FSC? So for Fe415, you have to take the value of the FSC from D dash upon D ratio table. So D dash upon D, you have to assume the effective power, you have to take the effective power 50 and D is, so 50 divided by 450, it is 0.11. It's 0.11. Okay. So I have the value. Okay. For Fe415. For Fe415. So the value is point. So that it is say as 0.1. So little bit for Fe415, D dash upon D ratio 0.05. So the FAC is 355 megapascal. Okay, and D dash upon D 0.075, FAC is 354 megapascal. So you have to interpolate this value, or you have to take the little bit the approximate value to find out the FSC, because this value is not so much affecting the accuracy of your compression steel calculation. Okay, so let's assume the value in between this, that means it is 354. So you have to take the value, you have to, because your D dash upon D ratio is, I have to take one more value. It is 0.1, because 0.1 value is directly available in table. So FAC is 0.1 is 350. We have the value of FAC for D dash upon D ratio 0.1. So directly to take the 353 newton per mm square. Use that value and find out the compression steel, that is 353. D is 450, and again you have to assume the DC value, that means DC value, that means effective power for compression steel 50 mm, 25.88 divided by 353 into 400. Okay, so this is a 183.28 mm square. For that, if you assume 16 mm bar diameter, so divided by pi by 4, 16 into 16, it is 0.91. That means you have to provide the 1 bar, but at top 1 bar is not sufficient, minimum 2 bars you have to provide. So I am going to provide 2 bars at top. So like this you have to design the compression steel. Now what about the shear reinforcement? That means you have to first sketch the whatever till now you designed, that is 250 mm width of the section. Okay, so these are the alignment axis of the bars. Okay, and 50 mm bar already you assume. 16 mm two bars you have assumed at top, and 25 mm four bars. 25 mm four bars you have designed for the tension steel at bottom. Now what next you have to do? So 50 mm cover, same cover you have to provide horizontally. Okay, 50 mm cover, same cover you have to provide horizontally. Okay, now shear reinforcement, design of shear reinforcement. Okay, for design of shear reinforcement you need to calculate the B1 D1. Okay, you need to calculate the B1 D1. For that okay, if the bottom and top bar diameter are different, so there is little bit some gap in between length and top bars practically. Okay, that you have to consider. So step number 4, design of shear reinforcement. Step number 4, design of shear reinforcement. For that you have to assume the form of shear reinforcement. So assume 8 mm diameter two-legged stirrups. 8 mm diameter two-legged stirrups. Okay, so these are the 8 mm diameter two-legged stirrups. Now what is the value of B1? What is the value of B1? So 250 minus 50 from this, 50 from this side, that means it is 150. Deduct 100 mm from this dimension. Okay, and total depth is 500 mm. Total depth of beam is 500 mm. So you have to deduct 50 from this, 50 from this. So D1 is 400 mm. Now what is the X1 and Y1? So as per consideration, X1 is, and as per the consideration, Y1 is. So I will calculate it. How to calculate X1? X1 is, so this is B1, 150. Okay, plus half of this diameter, half of the 25, half of the 25, 12.5, that means you have to add 25, plus half of this 8, half of this 8. Okay, so the X1 is 150 plus 25 plus 8 is 183 mm. X1 is 183 mm. What is the Y1? Y1 is total, D1 is 400 plus half of the 25 is 12.5, half of the 16 is 8, plus 4, that means 8. Okay, so 400 plus 12.5 plus 8 plus 8, it is 428.5 mm. Is it clear? 400 plus half of this 25 is 12.5, half of this 16 is 8, then half of this 8 is 4, half of this 8 is 4. Okay, that you have to add. So it is 428.5 mm. So these are the simple calculations of X1 and Y1. I will rub this. And now you have to find out the spacing. And now you have to find out the spacing using first formula, that is ASV is equal to TU into SV divided by b1 d1 into 0.87 fy plus vu into sv divided by 2.5 d1 into 0.87 fy. So asv for 8 mm 2 little bar we have so many times in previous problem calculated is 100.53. okay, 100.53. TU torsional moment is 60 into 10^6. SV you have to find out. B1 is 150, B1 is 400, 0.87 FY is 415 plus BU ultimate shear force is 80 into 10^3 SV divided by 2.5 D1. D1 is 400, 0.87 FY is 415. Okay. So now what are the values? Okay, so I will calculate it. Please try to calculate with me. So the value is 2.76 SV plus 0.22 SV, 100.53. Now what is the SV? It is 33.73 mm only, 33.73 mm. Okay, second, the ASV is tau VE minus tau C B into SV divided by 0.87 FY. okay, value of tau VE is 4.12, tau C is 0.51, width is 250, SV have to find out, 0.87 FY is 415, ASV is 100.53. now let's calculate the SV. Okay, so it is 4.12 minus 0.51, 4.12 minus 0.51, okay, into 250 divided by 0.87 FY is this. It is, this particular value is 2.59 SV. This particular value is 2.59 SV. So 100.53 divided by 49, it is 40.37. So this is the spacing from, this is spacing from second formula. Okay, what we get? We get the spacing from first formula is 33.73. Spacing from first formula is 33.73 mm. Spacing from second formula is 40.37 mm, and spacing should not exceed, as per the IS code, the spacing should not exceed, the spacing should not exceed, first entry is x1, we have the value 183 mm. okay, second one, x1 plus y1 by 4, 183 plus 428.5 by 4. So 183 plus 428.5 by 4, the value is 152.87 mm. okay, 875 mm. And third is 300 mm. So whichever is less, so to provide the less value from this 5 values, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this one is less value, so you have to provide 33 mm center to center. So as per my consideration, this is very less value. If the spacing is less than 30 or 25 mm, you have to increase the spacing between the stirrups by increasing the legs, or you have to increase the diameter of the stirrups. Diameter of stirrups, that you can increase the spacing between the stirrups. When you feel that this is very less value, you have to do these things. That means increase the legs of the stirrups or increase the diameter of stirrups. Now what you have to do, you have to provide 2 leg 8 mm diameter stirrups, 2 leg 8 mm diameter stirrups. Now I will give you the final design of beam for this problem. Okay, so I will provide this. Okay, these things are now not required. So 16 mm diameter 2 bars, okay, you can write like this, or 25 mm diameter 4 bars like this, and 8 mm 2 leg stirrups, okay, at 33 mm center to center. Let you have to adopt this spacing for the stirrups. Now what about the side face reinforcement? So what about the side face T overall depth of beam? If exceeds 450 mm, our overall depth is 500 mm. It exceeds 450 mm, so you have to design the side face reinforcement also. So side face steel required, and that AST side face is 0.1% of wave area. 0.1% of wave area, that means 0.1 divided by 100 into width of the section is 250. Width of the section is 250 and depth of the section is 500. Okay, so 250 into 500 is, I think it is 125 mm². So provide 12 mm diameter. Let us assume the 12 mm bar and provide the number of bars, 125 divided by pi by 4 into 12 into 12. Correctly, it is 1.10. That means 2 bars you have to provide. Okay, that means 12 mm diameter 2 bars you have to provide as side face steel. That means, okay, 12 mm diameter 2 bars. So this is the total design of this beam.